Welcome, welcome, and hello to Dragon Age 201, your spoilery guide to the world of Dragon Age. I'm Gilda Thalin, your lore archivist, and today I'm going to help you quickly understand the basics of the Blight. Please keep in mind that if you have not played the games before and want to play the entire series, you are going to want my Dragon Age 101 video over the same content linked below. The Magister's Sidereal. The first point in understanding the Blight is to know why they happen in the first place, and for that, we need to talk about the Golden City. In the Fade, no matter where you are, when you were dreaming, there is a floating castle in the sky. This castle has a few names, but was once known as the Golden City. As the Chantry tells us, this is where the Maker lived. Over 1,000 years before the start of the games, the old gods that Devinter worship whispered to their high priests that they were to break into the Golden City at the heart of the Fade. And they did so, and by Chantry accounts, once they breached the veil and stepped foot into the Golden City, the Maker threw them out blighted, and the Golden City was corrupted, turning black, and thus those in Thedas began to call it the Black City. These Magisters brought the Blight into the world, and its taint would spread until those tainted scurried into the dark depths of the underground, carried by the sweet musical calling that those blighted hear. Eventually, they found the old god Dumat, freed and tainted him, and thus began the first Blight. In both Dragon Age Origins and Dragon Age Inquisition, we meet two different members of the seven high priests that broke into the Golden City, although only one actually remembers doing so. From his account, there was no god, his or otherwise, in the Golden City, and that it was already tainted when they arrived. There are also codex entries of more magisters lurking in the deep roads, although from these reports, it seems they largely don't remember who they were. The Blights. We assume that, as so far at the head of every Blight is an archdemon, that there will only be as many Blights as there are old gods. However, Solas, who knows a lot more about the Blight than he lets on, describes this as being a bad idea to kill all the archdemons. At this point, we don't really know why. With that knowledge, Thedas has defeated 5 of the possible 7. They have gotten shorter with each passing Blight thanks to the Grey Wardens, an ancient order created to be vigilant in stopping the Blights. After an archdemon is slain, the spawns scuttle back down into the deep roads where they hide in the darkness and search for the next old god and rebuild their numbers. The surface people forget and move on, trying to rebuild what they lost, but for the underground dwarves, there is no forgetting. The Blights decimated their world, and for the two living Taigs, Orzammar and Kael Sharrok, Blights end up being a mixed blessing. The darkspawn that used to beat at the gates now march to the surface, giving them a moment's peace. The Blight Disease. When someone is blighted, usually by coming into contact with something that carries the Blight and then the taint entering their bloodstream, they begin to turn into a ghoul. Their body will start to break down, hair and nails will fall out, clumps of flesh itched away, and a beautiful song in their head that takes over all of their thoughts. They must follow this calling. It's all they can think of. At this moment in Thedas, there is no cure to this process, but there is a way to slow it down. The Grey Wardens have developed a process known as the Joining, which helps them slow down and protect its members from succumbing to the Blight. All Wardens undergo the Joining, a process that involves drinking darkspawn blood, blood of an archdemon, and lyrium. But not all recruits survive this process, with some dying on the spot. Those that survive will have some positive side effects, like more stamina, extra strength, and the ability to sense darkspawn that are nearby. However, while Wardens can live many decades after being blighted, the Blight will eventually win, and it's customary for those too far gone to travel to where the darkspawn lay and die in battle. The Darkspawn. There are different types of darkspawn, and they can be separated into two groups. Ghouls, who were once living beings and have been tainted, and true darkspawn, creatures born of the Blight. The Archdemon is the leader of the spawn and believed to be quite intelligent. While technically a ghoul, as these creatures are believed to once be the old gods of Devinter, most documents list them among the true darkspawn. They use the calling of the Blight to give orders to the darkspawn and ravage the world. No one is quite certain what their goal is, other than to destroy. Archdemons also have a unique ability compared to other darkspawn. If killed by any non-tainted creature, their soul will jump to another darkspawn and the dragon will be born anew. The only way to truly kill an archdemon is for a warden to make the killing blow, as the soul will enter the blighted warden. We aren't sure why, but this ends the process, killing both the archdemon and the warden that made the killing blow. In Dragon Age Origins, we also learn from Morrigan that this can be bypassed. Morrigan can become pregnant by a Grey Warden, and she uses the fetus of the child she is carrying to absorb the old god's soul. With the infant being so young, the souls do not counteract, and they can coexist peacefully. The one old god baby we have seen, Kieran, seems like a normal boy, but does say some strange things and seems to have very powerful magic. If he exists, the old god's soul was removed from him in an inquisition by Flemeth, and he seems to have lost these abilities. Brood mothers are perhaps the worst of the darkspawn. These ghouls used to be females of any given race, and once twisted and tainted, they now birth hundreds of true darkspawn. It should be noted that not all women who are tainted turn into broodmothers, however. Of those that do meet that horrible fate, their race determines which creatures they spawn. Herlocks are born of human broodmothers. Shrieks, also called Sharlocks, are born of elven broodmothers. Genlocks are born of dwarven broodmothers, and ogres are born of Qunari broodmothers. Young darkspawn grow rapidly, and those that end up stronger and more intelligent than others of its brood are alphas, leading groups of spawn as their commander. Other darkspawn, including even alphas, can find that they are able to use magic. These are called emissaries, and they use a strange type of magic rooted in blood magic, but using the blight. On their own, these creatures feed and destroy everything they touch, but not all are mindless. They are able to fashion weapons and armor, stealing what they need from the living. They fashion strange statues for reasons unknown to us, and even traps to kill as many as they can. And that, my dear Delens, are the basics of the Blight. If you would like to learn more about certain subjects, I've linked a playlist below with more comprehensive videos on a wide variety of subjects mentioned here. So until next time, Duresh Sharal.